doing, Valerie Jarrett?
Hello.
Tell me your name.
Jessica.
Hey, Jessica.
Kal Penn.
Hi.
Nice to meet you.
My project focused on the eye muscles and your peripheral vision. So I noticed that a lot of my friends and I have glasses, and everyone in my family's got eye problems. So I wanted to see whether there was a way to keep your eyes strong and to keep your peripheral vision staying wide and to improve it. So then I invented three devices.
Would that be the eye? Yeah.
So you just put it up to your forehead and you follow the lights with your eyes to exercise your eyes.
Oh, wow.
Would you like to try?
Yes. So I follow
the lights.
All right.
And then I asked 19 test subjects from the ages 12 to 81 to do this for as long as they could, four times over a period of 1 to 2 weeks. And I saw that they could endure the test longer and longer every time they
You're
did
kidding.
It.
You're kidding.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
That's kind of awesome. You have a robotics team at your school?
Yes.
Wow. You didn't have one at your school?
I did not. And if we did, I would be the guy doing the voice for the robot. Do you guys have a background in physics? Do you have to know anything about physics to do this?
Well, physics is actually my favorite subject. So.
Okay.
So, yeah.
At some point, I want you to explain time dilation to me, but not right now. That's a whole separate conversation, but that's awesome. So that's your what's your favorite subject?
My favorite subject is anything pertaining to science or math.
Okay.
That's what I love. And we go for engineering students. So when you apply for high school in the eighth grade, if you write down Mergenthaler, you also have to write down a trade next to it. The trade is to serve a purpose of educating you in a career you might want to pursue. We have anything from the medical field, engineering, carpentry, plumbing, masonry.
Mm-hmm.
So I put down engineering and he put down engineering.
So what do you think you want to do when you're all grown up?
I'm thinking either software engineering or nuclear physics.
Wow.
And
I
you?
I want to be a mechanical engineer.
Well, I think it's the number one or at least top three, I don't want to get it wrong, emerging fields over the next 20 years are in engineering. More companies are going to come back here for manufacturing.
It's a growth.
We need innovators, so I'm sure you guys are going to do very well, and I assume we'll buy devices like this from them.
Absolutely.
At some point.
I was in an entrepreneurship class, and we just had to think of something we were really passionate about, and children happened to be something I'm very passionate about, and so I decided to develop this app.
So tell us about it. And assume I know nothing.
Same
at
here,
all.
By the way.
Okay.
The camp provider has access to this chart where, for a certain activity, when an activity is done, they can check it off and say that it's done. And so, as you can see, the button disappear and the app changed colors.
Oh, so you can track what they're doing, the schedule in the course of the day?
Yes. This is where the parent will put in the activity. Each section, each bracket is set for a certain time in the chart. So this one is down here because it's set for this time.
I see.
Okay.
This is also the chat where if you just want to see your baby for a little while, you can go to FaceTime.
I noticed you're outlining the problem really well, right? So it's attacking the issue of single parents have a tougher time. Obviously, this helps. Have you had the chance to test it at all with folks?
I've done surveys where parents said that this app would make their day easier or make their week easier.
That's terrific.
This is awesome.
Well, as a single mom, I thank you. My daughter's a little old for this now, but it would have sure come in handy about 25 years ago. So good luck to you.
This is very bright and awesome.
That's what I said. There was a lot of lights going on.
How did you learn to code and what made you interested in that?
Well, my teachers actually taught me how to code using this. And what got me interested was some people, like the volunteers from Cognizant, they came in and they gave a presentation of what they do in that the apprenticeship. So I thought of it and I got to pick three apprenticeships that I wanted to be in, and I got chosen in this.
We are so proud of you.
Cool.
And I like that you're trying to encourage people to have confidence in their self as a way of making sure you don't get bullied. A big thing that we do at the White House that we worked on together is to try to raise people's awareness and self-confidence and mutual respect so that you could have your own identity and not have to worry about other people judging you. But it looks like you found something very special here. It's fun, huh? Good. Well, what you're doing is very cool.